إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، يقول سفيان الثوري رضي الله عنه. سفيان الثوري is one of the Tabi'een, born in year 97, and he was referred to as أعمل العاملين. He is faqih, muhaddith, is a great scholar, and he is referred to as the best of those who act. And that is the fruit of the knowledge. If you have the knowledge and you don't act upon it, that's the worst thing that you can do. So he is faqih, and he is muhaddith, and he is عامل. من العاملين يقول ما بقي من نعيم الدنيا إلا ثلاث. Three things left for me in the pleasure of this dunya. أخٌ في الله ثقة أكسب من صحبته خيرا. أخٌ في الله ثقة أكسب من صحبته خيرا. A brother I love for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I benefit from his friendship. It's not for a goal, it's not because he is funny or because he is rich or because whatever reason. I want to benefit from him, fillah, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah, and he was great stories between not just the Sahaba but the Tabi'een and those who came after them, how they take care of one another and visit one another. When one of them is so sick and the other one is sick too, but he goes and visits him. And a great incident that happened between Imam al-Shafi'i and Imam Ahmad rahimahullah. Imam al-Shafi'i, he visited him and he said a couple of lines. He said, أحب الصالحين ولست منهم عسى أن أنال بهم شفاعة وأكره من بضاعته المعاصي وأكره من بضاعته المعاصي وإن كنا سواء في البضاعة. And he said, I love righteous people and I'm not one of them. Maybe I will gain an intercession by this love, because the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the opportunity for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to intercede, then the friends also will intercede for one another. Imagine the intercession of the friends, even if it was one time you met the person, one time, and you benefited from him, he will intercede for you and that meeting will benefit you. That's how important it is to know who your friends are and what are you gaining from them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would ask the person, it's like you sit in Jannah and you're having fun and everything and you look around and it's like, brother so-and-so, where is he? Oh, he's not here, he's in hell. Oh Allah, I will not be happy unless he is here. He said, go get him. So he goes and calls on him from hellfire. And imagine, he's in hellfire. All the people in hellfire, it's like who's that guy? Is that your brother? Is that your relative? Is that someone? He said, no, I just met him one time. Then some of the scholars said, they recite, فَمَا لَنَا مِنْ شَافِعِينَ وَلَا صَدِيقٍ حَمِيمٍ. We have no intercessors and we don't have a friend, even just a close friend, who will intercede for us. So Imam al-Shafi'i said that, and Imam Ahmad retaliated to praise him and compliment. He said, تُحِبُّ الصَّالِحِينَ وَأَنْتَ مِنْهُمْ. If you know it, brother, come and say it. You know it? رَفِيقُ الْقَوْمِ يَلْحَقُ بِالْجَمَاعَةِ. He said, I'm not one of them. And he told him, you're from him. Even if you're not righteous, if you are with righteous people, you'll be associated with them. And yahalla, for instance, in this gathering, the rahmah descends. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions your name. And tranquility descends, forgiveness and everything. Maybe one of you brothers, not coming really for the lecture, not coming even to listen to a lecture, just happens to be there. You will gain that blessing along with everyone else. Because this is a group that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not let anyone suffer amongst them. And the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he continued, وَتَكْرَهُ مَنْ بِضَاعَتَهُ الْمَعَاصِي حَمَاكَ اللَّهُ مِنْ تِلْكَ الْبِضَاعَةِ. And you hate those people who all they do is sinful, يعني they're not righteous people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you from such a bida'a or such a commerce or business or people. So he said, three things left in this dunya. Righteous friend, I gain from him khayra. What's the khayr that he wants to gain? قال إن رآني زائغا قومني. If he sees me deviate, stop. Most of us, mashy. He is a friend, you don't want to hurt his feeling. You don't want to say it. It's not the right time. You know, he's sensitive. No, he's saying, I want the friend who corrects me. When I'm wrong, he tells me stop. وَإِن رَآنِي مُسْتَقِيمًا رَغَّبَنِي. And if he sees me, mashallah, mashallah, he tells me, mashallah, mashallah. MashaAllah, you come, brother, every dhuhr prayer here? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you. Wallahi, I wish I can do the same thing that you do. Now his head will become this big. He will come dhuhr and asr and maghrib and isha and everything. This is good. This is good because everybody likes this. They don't ask for it, but it feels good when you feel like you're recognized, just like children. If you see a child doing something and you tell him, mashallah, you did that yourself, he will be encouraged to do all of that thing. Same thing, human being. We all love compliments, and that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to show gratitude to one another and to thank and to reward and to do all of that. Still human being. So if you are wrong, he will fix it. And if you are right, he will encourage you to do it. So basically, in both ways, he's with you. Most of us, and there's an awesome story that I heard yesterday. Most of us, he is my friend, and mashallah, every day he hugs me and he kisses me and he welcomes me and all that. I'm the same. Invite, go, eat, and everything. And then something goes wrong between us. Complete desertion. It's like we've never known each other. It's like we never loved each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kullu left taht al-lihan. Kullu your friend just haki. Words that doesn't exceed here. You just happen to be in a good mood, or you just like the person for whatever reason. You find the person at time of disagreement. That's when you know your friend. That's why one of the righteous predecessors said, إِذَا أَرَدْتَ أَن تَتَّخِذَ صَدِيقًا فَأَغْضِبْ فَإِنْ أَنصَفَكَ فَهُوَ هُوَ. If you want to have a friend, anger him. If he's fair, then that's the one. What does that mean, fair? It's not like he doesn't respond or doesn't affect him or doesn't do anything to him. No, it does, but he doesn't exceed limits. He retaliates, but within limits, within what lawful in Islam. It's not like إِذَا خَاصَمَ فَجَرَ. You exceed the limits with that. So just to give you an example, the story from what I recall, he said two friends were so close to each other and really, really love each other. But this is true love. true love for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They disagreed and it became so bad between them, they don't talk. And their neighbors, one of them, guests came over and it was time of majara, there was not much food available. And you know the generosity of the people. They want to take care of the guest. So he doesn't have anything, and this is just an embarrassing moment. Someone visits you and you don't take care of them. He knows his friend, the one he doesn't talk to, has little goats and sheep. Watch this. You will know what kind of friend you have and how you deal with your friends and what does it mean to disagree and how far the limit can go with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذهب إلى بيته والرجل أمام البيت صاحب وزوجته معه دخل على الحديقة لم يقل حتى السلام عليكم. He went to his house while he's at the door with his wife. He did not even say السلام عليكم. Remember, they don't talk. He passed by him, went to his yard, took a goat, took it to his house. Before he started, he was leaving, and his wife is saying, look what your friend did. He's taking the sheep. He whispered to her, shh, don't talk. He doesn't talk to me. If he's not really in need for it, he will not take it. Look at the love. It's not like, hey, where do you think you're going? This is my house. شايف حالك. So the message here, yeah, it's okay. We disagree. We have problems. We might even fight. We might even hit each other. But it's not the end of the life. I mean, you will have disagreement. How many times you fight with your wife, brother? If you want to divorce your wife every time you fight with her, how many wives are you going to have? And if your friend, every time you disagree with him, same thing. Number one, friend. So what does the friend do? Fixes you when you do wrong. That's one na'im. This is a blessing in this life. And if you do right, what happens? He encourages you. قال ورزق واسع حلال. Great sustenance. Halal sustenance. ليس لله علي فيه تبعة ولا لمخلوق علي فيه منة. That I have a lot of money, but I don't have anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have right in it, and I did not do. Zakah, perfectly paid. When people need help, I'm always there. Halal money. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to come and tell me why you got this or why you didn't do this. I'm taking care of it. And people, no one can come and say, I'm the one who did this, I'm the one who gave you that. Alhamdulillah, blessed by myself, taking care of the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and taking care of the rights of people, and no one is taking care of me. And finally, and this is the one that I want you to focus on, قال صلاة في جماعة أكفى سهوها وأكسب أو أنال أجرها. And a prayer with jama'ah, like you did, أكفى سهوها. If you forget and you did not pay attention, you miss something from the sunnah, from such in the salah, because you're in jama'ah, because you're with the imam takes care of it. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you for it because you're with the imam. Even a pillar, you catch the prayer late, the imam read al-Fatiha. Can you pray without reading al-Fatiha? No. Can you pray without standing? No. There are pillars. But because with the imam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let it go. You don't have to read al-Fatiha. I'm going to count it for you. Because you are blessed with the imam. So those little mistakes that you have here and there, all forgiven. وَأَنَالُ أَجْرَهَا. and I am gaining the reward. يعني brother, if you pray 27 times عشاء at home, you will not catch up the reward of this prayer. 27 times, you will have gray hairs. I know you haven't already, but you'll have black hairs then. Can you imagine the reward for this? In fact, I want to verify this hadith, but I believe I read where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His blessing, because you're in jama'ah, He'll give you the reward of the one with the most khushu'. Yani here in the musalleen, how many people? I know our khushu' is not that high, but who has the highest? Let's say this brother has 60% khushu'. You will count 60% because you are in this jama'ah. ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَا يَشَاءُ. So brothers, look for the right friend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your wealth, and make sure you pay the dues, and pray in jama'ah at MIC. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.